Namaste. Whether we realize or not, every one of us carries with us a self-image. It is a mental blueprint of ourselves. This self-image is our own conception of what kind of person we are. It is built from our beliefs about ourselves. It has been unconsciously formed from our past experiences, our successes and failures, our honors and humiliations, and the way others have reacted to us, especially in our childhood. Once it is formed, it is true to ourselves as far as we are concerned. We do not question its validity, and we always proceed to act upon it as if it is just true. All your actions, behaviors, feelings, and even your abilities are always consistent with your self-image. Not only this, you cannot act otherwise. In spite of all your efforts and willpower, because the self-image is the base or foundation upon which your entire personality is built up, and you will act like the sort of person you conceive yourselves to be. The man who conceive himself to be failure type of person will find some way to fail. In spite of all his good intentions and willpower, even if the opportunity is literally dumped in his lap, the person who conceives himself to be a victim of injustice or the one who was meant to suffer will invariably find circumstances to verify his opinion. Research also confirmed that once a person believes in a particular aspect of his identity, he is more likely to act in alignment with the belief. So, your self-image or identity can work for you as a powerful force for your self-development, or it can work against you as a curse. If your self-image is positive and healthy, you can create positive habits and you can transform yourself. But when your self-image is negative and unhealthy, you cannot change positively. For example, you may be the person who says, "I am terrible with directions. I am not a morning person. I am always late. I am bad at remembering the names. I am horrible at math. I am not good with technology." When you have repeatedly tell this kind of story to yourself for a long period, this will be imprinted in your subconscious mind, and the subconscious mind will accept them as facts. Eventually, you will begin to act and resist the positive actions, because the self-image tells that this is not the person who I am. Because there will be tremendous pressure in yourself to maintain the self-image, to act accordingly. Your subconscious mind will not allow you to contradict yourself. The more deeply a thought or actions is tied to your self-identity, the more difficult it is to change it. The biggest barrier to positive change is identity conflict. Good habits can make rational sense, but if they are not in alignment with your beliefs, and if they are in conflict with your self-image, you will fail to put them in actions. So, the fourth tip to change yourself positively is change the self-image or self-identity. Thankfully, numerous case studies have shown that one is never too young or too old to change the self-image or identity and thereby start a new life. So you can change your self-image at any point of time in your life. Find out what are the negative aspects of your self-image. Find what is blocking your progress in changing the habits. How to change it? Let us discuss about it next Wednesday. Thank you.